and has been the signature sound of Memphis International Raceway since it opened in the late 1980s.
I have been down this strip of asphalt right here at over 330 miles an hour in a quarter mile.
Clay Milliken from Drummond, Tennessee is a six-time IHRA world champion who's grown up racing at this facility near Millington. He shocked the drag strip, two drift tracks, an autocross, and a NASCAR track could soon be closed and demolished, possibly making way for a warehouse complex.
It's just such a family-oriented spot that you hate to see it go away for another warehouse.
This approximately 380 acres is owned by IRG Sports and Entertainment in Florida, a company that organizes various motorsports events. No one at their Palm Beach office returned our calls about plans for the raceway, but the track's GM tells WREG he's done everything he can to keep the property from closing.
I was in the process of trying to buy the place along with a business partner, and we placed a bid of what we were told would pretty much get the place on Friday. On Monday, another company had put another bid in, and it was a great deal more than what we had bid.
We've been unable to find out the name of the company that outbid Miles and his partner, but Miles says the deal could all boil down to whether the raceway property could be rezoned from entertainment to light industrial. The raceway has been a popular spot for NASCAR competition as well. But the big concern for Jeff Miles is how this possible closing of Memphis International Raceway will add to the already dangerous activity called street racing.
When you lose this facility, your drifters, your street racers, your drag racers, they all go back to the street and they'll street race, which is certainly unsafe.
Alex Coleman, WREG-TV, News Channel 3.